our COAS student speakers, the department chairs of the college, our esteemed faculty members, Dr. Tavares serving as faculty marshal, the 2024 flagship student ambassadors serving as student marshals, our keynote speaker, Dr. Karim Merrick, and the 2023 COAS Bachelor of Arts candidates for degree. Thank you.
Let's give our graduates another round of applause. I would like to give a special welcome to our graduates, our esteemed faculty, and our distinguished guests. It is my absolute privilege and blessing to stand before you all today and offer this year's invocation speech to celebrate the achievements of the Howard University College of Arts and Sciences class of 2023, the best class. Today is a momentous occasion, because today we honor the beginning of our legacies and the accomplishment of all of our aspirations. We celebrate the end of a momentous chapter, but the beginning of a new one, filled with endless possibilities and prospects if you dare to dream big. We all came to Howard University with a dream, whether it was to continue the legacy set by our parents, whether it was to be the first in our family to graduate college, or whether it was to find your Howard husband. We all had a dream. But each of us had a desire, an ambition, and a longing to become something, to be someone. And that someone is someone who perseveres, perseverance, tenacity, and pursuit, and inspires their friends and their family and the community around them. As I look around this room today, I see just that. You see, Howard is not easy. And as much as we may not realize it, it strikes some scary similarities to a song that we all know far too well. From the highs to the lows, the triumphs to the struggles, the moments of doubt to the moments of victory, these past years have been dreams and nightmares, and that is word to Meek Mill. Whether it was the all-nighters we pulled to finish a paper or study for that exam, or the times we struggle to balance our schoolwork and our extracurriculars, family obligations, jobs, the stress and financial burden of undergrad, our first loss, or when we didn't make the cut for a certain org. Maybe one of our dreams got deferred, or we failed a test. Maybe the pandemic is what put a strain on our academic prowess. Maybe we felt like we lost someone, or maybe we felt like we were losing ourselves. Maybe it was the moments we doubted ourselves and wondered if we were ever good enough to make it to graduation day. But for all the dreams that we didn't achieve, we made new ones. Because honestly, if we all stuck to our first dreams, the world would be overrun by princesses and astronauts, and I don't think we can use those. What I'm saying is, don't be afraid to think big because of the nightmares or the failures you think that you may face, because it sharpens you. It challenges you. It makes you stronger. It's when you run away from those adversities that you run away from the opportunity to become your best self. With all that we have endured from our different walks of life, we leave here with something in common: the tools to dream outside of the box. We know what failure looks like, and seeing as we all made it here today, we know how to overcome it. We are Howard University graduates. Howard University alumna. So what could possibly stop us from aspiring for greater? We have sat in the seats of Chadwick Boseman, Kamala Harris, Toni Morrison, Thurgood Marshall, and other change makers who have gone on confidently in the direction of their dreams to make themselves and the world around them better. I live my life by one motto. And that says, in order to acquire something that you have never had, you must do something that you have never done. I must make the sacrifices, be empowered, ignore the naysayers, have the courage, take the risks, and let my education be the most powerful weapon I can use to change the world. And I don't know, I'm going to Harvard after this, so I think that that motto might be working. Ultimately, tomorrow belongs to the people who prepare for it today, who dream about it today. And I reckon that this graduating class is a graduating class of dreamers who will stop at nothing to overcome their failures and create a long-lasting legacy that succeeds them. In the opening line of Dreams and Nightmares, Meek says something like, "Ain't this what they've been waiting for? Are you ready?" And as we reflect on this journey to where we are today, I think it's safe to say that the Howard University College of Arts and Sciences class of 2023 has arrived, and we are prepared to take on the world, because if we dream big enough, there is nothing that we have already accomplished that is greater than what we are still yet to achieve. And boy, will we dream. So I think we're ready. Thank you.
You may be seated. Honored COAS graduates, pillars of the College of Arts and Sciences, members of the dais, distinguished faculty, dedicated staff, our guests of honor, our keynote speaker, and proud parents and friends, bien bonjour. Bonjour, good afternoon. Welcome to the Burr Gymnasium for the Howard University College of Arts and Sciences ceremony, recognition ceremony for the Social Sciences and Humanities. I am Dr. Francis, Associate Dean for Academic Student Affairs in the College of Arts and Sciences. And today, I have the honor of serving as your Master of Ceremony. Dear class of 2023, you?
You know.
That's right. You know that today marks your monumental achievements. You know that there's no place like the maker. You know that you are making history. You stand on the shoulders of pillars. Your ancestors are standing strong and proud with you today. Yes, indeed. You are part of the rich history and legacy of the illustrious Howard University. What you've gained here at Howard is memorable, and it is yours for life. Mm-hmm. This Mecca experience is like your tuition and fee. It is not refundable. What you have learned at Howard is that you are not too much. You are excellence. That you are not an omission, but everything. That you have everything to be successful, that you are smart, bold, beautiful, creative, and Mecca fashionable. Today, we are here to tell you how much we are extremely proud of you, to remind you that we are grateful to you for the voices you will make heard and for the ways in which you will engage with issues of diversity and growing gaps in the economic fortunes of our social fabric. We know that you will use the education that you have received to launch and sustain efforts that will forge significant differences in your communities, the nation, and the world, because you have everything to do so. Congratulations to you on this big achievement. And now, I would like to call to the podium Dr. Anthony Wuto, the Provost and Chief Academic Officer of Howard University, to bring greetings and recognition of parents and guests.
Good afternoon, class of 2023. This is a day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Before I make my brief comments, I want to first acknowledge my colleagues, the distinguished faculty of the College of Arts and Sciences. I will ask if they will stand and be acknowledged by your graduates. And for the group we've all come here for, I will ask the class of 2023 to stand and be acknowledged. And while you are standing, I want you to find your families, your parents, your grandmothers, your uncles and aunts, and thank them for supporting you to be here today. You may be seated. And earlier when I was greeting your colleagues from natural sciences, there was a group that I wanted to recognize and acknowledge in particular. So if you are the first in your family to graduate from college, I want you to stand up and be recognized. Because you represent the fulfillment of the hopes and dreams and the prayers of your ancestors who couldn't be here today, who may not even have seen you, but knew that you would fulfill their dreams. Congratulations. To the entire class of 2023, I salute you. My daughter is one of your classmates. She's graduating from the School of Communications. And so she would on occasion share with me things that students were saying, the things that you were worrying about. Yes, she did show me some of your tweets too. And she would share with me the things that you were aspirational about and the things that you were fearful of. Do you remember when you first came to Howard University and how wonderful campus was and the freedom that you experienced? And then COVID came and we were in lockdown and you were in isolation. Do you remember that? Do you remember the things that you have overcome, the multiple bomb threats that we were receiving that were intended to prevent you from being here today? Do you remember the criminal cyber attack that we experienced? Do you remember the threats to democracy, all of the craziness that was going on? All of those things could have been obstacles to prevent you to be here today, but you persevered. You have succeeded in spite of the obstacles. You have each other to thank for that. You have your parents and families and support system to thank for that. You have the faculty and staff to thank for that. But most of all, you have God to thank for allowing you to be here today. Because what God has ordained for you, no one can stand in the way of. Amen? And so I will share with you one of my favorite scriptures, and I will be seated from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 29, verse 11. For I know the plans that I have for you, saith the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Congratulations, and God bless you.
Thank you, Provost Wouter, for these uplifting words. Your schedule is very busy, and it never prevented you from modeling service and from providing such tremendous and generous level of humanity to our students. So we thank you for so powerfully taking the time to share space with our graduates and for bringing greetings to them and their families. Jeanne Christina, are you here? Where are you? Would you stand? Here she is. Dear members of the audience, Jeanne is a proud first-generation college graduate. Her mother is the biggest inspiration in her life. Jeanne recently convinced her mother to go back to school to pursue her passion. Her mother had her graduation ceremony today and skipped it to be at Jeanne's. Miss Charmaine Francois, would you please stand up? So we can acknowledge you today for this double graduation celebration. Madame Francois, we thank you for the wonderful job you've done with your only child. We also congratulate you on your major achievement as you waited 30 years to graduate from college. Jeanne and Miss Francois, we thank you both for allowing us to witness such intergenerational love, dedication, and inspiration. Thank you. And now, I would like to bring to the podium the captain of our flagship, a leader whose efforts are paramount when it comes to modernizing the academy, supporting our students' transformative experiential learning, and sustaining tools that educate them so they can make meaningful contributions as citizens of a complex world. Please help me to warmly welcome our Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences, Dr. Ruben Patterson.
Thank you, Dr. Francis. Good evening, everyone. And a special good evening to our 2023 graduates. All of Howard's, yes, it's okay to clap if you like, that's fine. All of Howard's COAS graduating classes are special, of course, but your graduating class will always be special for me because we started our new chapters at Howard together. You no doubt started your journey towards your degree, and I started my journey as the Dean of COAS in the fall of 2019. Both of us have learned a lot, and we've had a lot of fun over the last few years. You've enjoyed your, overall you've enjoyed your educational experience, and I have enjoyed learning the job in order to better serve you and to serve our faculty so both groups can actually succeed. And I don't know if you recall this, but at freshman orientation in Crampton Auditorium in fall 2019, when we thought we were gonna be using Crampton Auditorium a lot, but who knew that the pandemic was around the corner. Somebody said they knew, okay. I wish you had told the rest of us. but at freshman orientation in fall 2019 and in August, I referred to you as future Howard alumni. I didn't address you as freshman, because I was thinking about this day coming very, very soon. But tomorrow I can drop the future and just say welcome you as alumni, because tomorrow you will have your prestigious Howard University degree, a degree that signals to the world that you have been very well educated and that you are prepared intellectually for professional and civic leadership. Your Howard University degree will open doors of opportunity for you, and the knowledge and the skills and the discipline that you have learned over the past few years in your pursuit of degree will make it such that you will be able to take full advantage of all of the opportunities that come your way. As members of the Gen Z generation, your predisposition is toward more fairness and tolerance for humankind throughout the world. But as students who were determined to receive your higher education at Howard University, it is evident that you had an even greater impulse towards the creation of social justice. You have been educated by a faculty who was attracted to Howard University, not only because they thought that Howard could help advance their individual careers, but they also wanted to be a part of Howard's storied legacy of producing major change makers. Howard is simply home to a faculty whose scholarly engagement is collectively oriented towards effecting meaningful social change. Students obviously learn a great deal from that impressive faculty, that committed faculty, but students also learn a great deal over their 4 years of college attendance outside the classroom, in residence halls, and in co-curricular activities, and in any number of the hundreds of student organizations on campus that all of you have been a part of in one way or another. So just as you have learned and grown a lot intellectually and in maturity, partly from your interactions with the impressive Howard University faculty, but you have also learned and grown from your fellow students, whom you have found to be just as smart and as ambitious as you are. During your years at Howard University as students, you have learned from and you have contributed to the growth of other students. And the rigorous and the culturally relevant Howard University and very special educational experience is now forever in your brain and in your soul. After tomorrow, you will pivot to taking ownership of this rapidly changing world that you're going to inherit. Consider, for example, how the world has changed significantly just since your birth generation of the Gen Z, which of course extended from the mid-1990s to the mid-2010s. Those of us who were born in decades before this, we've had to learn this new world in which you are simply natives. Transformational technology and products founded only since your birth a little over 2 years ago include Wi-Fi and Netflix and streaming music, TikTok, other social media, Uber, Zoom, Airbnb, etc. Those of us who are older have had to learn this new world that this is the only world that you have ever known. Such big developments, though, are accelerating at such a pace that many individuals and many institutions are struggling to absorb and to adjust to these powerful forces of change. They are impacting people's mental health, and they are also weakening democratic institutions. And the latest example of this, of course, is artificial intelligence. You know, the new AI product, ChatGPT, was released only last year, and it was founded by an organization as recently as 2015. I'm just pointing this out that it's just that since you were in high school, a institution came into existence and has now unleashed a force that's going to transform, you know, literally the human experience in many respects. The transformational developments they're occurring at such a rate that it can be sort of, you know, downright scary. But I am just glad, I take heart in knowing that in many arenas where decisions will be made to confront these matters, that we're going to have Howard University graduates in those arenas. I say that because Howard University graduates are quite unique. I point four ways in which they are so unique. You, of course, chose Howard University for your educational experience, partially because you identify with Howard's long legacy of affecting social change for greater equity. I mean, that's Howard's DNA. You were also admitted to Howard University because of your keen intellect and your very high potential. That's what we saw in you when we read through your application and admitted you to Howard University. And you've been educated by a faculty who are leaders in their respective fields of study, but who also intersperse thoughts of social justice, advancing social justice, irrespective of the discipline. You've been informed by that. And lastly, of course, you've also been further educated by your fellow peers. As you know, as I said, who are as bright, as one student said to me, that, you know, she was a standout in high school, winning all sort of accolades, but she said she got here and found out that everybody's just as smart as she is. So, and again, all of that has contributed to your further growth and development. So I would just say, as I conclude, that your Howard education has helped you to become future ready. And your Howard Future Ready education has rendered you to be as prepared to grapple with these sweeping changes as well as any other college graduates in the country. And speaking of the future, at Howard University, just as I experienced when I was a student here, you've entered lifelong relationships with individuals who are going to be enormously successful. Some of these individuals are going to lead and run big and major and powerful organizations. Some of them are actually going to have their names, others will make national and international headlines. And of course, all of you, 2023 graduates, will embody excellence and truth and service in all that you do. So after tomorrow, I look forward to warmly welcoming all of you into the esteemed Howard University alumni. It's you.
My name is Mariah Cooley, and I am a graduating, almost graduated, senior political science major, strategic, legal, and management communications minor from Peoria, Illinois. Firstly, I'd like to thank God, my family, line sisters, friends, faculty, and more for pouring into me and empowering me to be here today. I would also like to give a special thanks to Dean Patterson, Dr. Francis, Dr. Evers, Mr. Morton, Ms. King, the entire Office of the Dean, and the entire Office of Campus Life for your continued guidance and support throughout my matriculation at Howard. My journey to and through Howard has not been traditional by any means. Being raised by parents who had me at 19 and 20, coming from a low-income background, and not knowing a single soul coming to campus, to say I was lost is an understatement. Even despite this initial feeling or fear, when you come to the Mecca, you instantly feel at home. Not necessarily a home that is comfortable, but a place that you know you're going to reach for your potential. Our campus, our class, is filled with beautiful people inside and out, coming from all walks of life with bright eyes and open arms. It just feels like just yesterday we were all freshmen. I remember going to Beak Week, staying up to date on Last Boston Standing, going to, I know y'all remember Beak Week, and looking on the hookup HU. I also learned how students managed to stay out partying until 4 a.m., but still getting up for their 8 a.m. and maintaining a 4.0 GPA. Yeah. I remember writing a letter to myself my freshman year, and it read, God gave you what you can handle, so handle it. Intense for an 18-year-old? Yes. But is this something that I carried with myself throughout my 4 years? Absolutely. When I walked across the stage, I wanted to say that I did it with no regrets. And everything was going perfect. I joined FLA, Jules Incorporated, ran for co-op secretary, and then the pandemic happened. Just as the sun was starting to shine, Rest Fest and Spring Fest were right around the corner. We went home for spring break and never came back. It's true. But we made the most of our pandemic era. Whether you took the leadership skills you learned at Howard to organizing your communities over the protests and unjust killings of George Floyd and Breonna Taylor, picked up a new hobby, did the infamous Chloe Ting two-week shred, or even did absolutely nothing, I am proud of you, I am proud of us. Despite the distance, I still felt a connection to my beloved university. Whether it was asking for help on GroupMe, even though most now use ChatGPT, or having talent shows on IG Live, we have leaned on each other. And then, before you know it, we were back on campus as upperclassmen. And not just any upperclassmen, we bore the responsibility of teaching those who came after us what we had learned within our short 7 months on campus. It felt like we were running out of time, and let's be honest, we lost the most out of our college experience, and it was not without trials and tribulations. As I said earlier in my speech, my journey to and through Howard has not been easy. I can say I've literally had a financial hole in my account every single semester at Howard. Howard's expensive. It's expensive. And yes, your former co-op council president and secretary, March for Our Lives national board member, Truman Scholar finalist, and former White House intern had a financial hold on her account, but she's here today. Thank you. And I can say that boldly and confidently because I've managed to overcome it all despite all circumstances. Even if you cannot relate to my experience, the lesson here is that everything is not what it seems. The biggest character lesson Howard taught me is that you only see the surface of what others allow you to see. But within the biggest lesson also came the biggest blessing, so because I am so grateful to have line sisters of Alpha, Kappa Alpha, Sorority Incorporated, Alpha Chapter, who allowed me to be vulnerable and have a sense of belonging. I hope as you all reflect on your experience at Howard, that you too were able to leave with a group of people who love you through the good and bad. Another surprisingly wise thing my freshman year self wrote in my letter was, if you are afraid to fall, you will never stand. The first thing you were told at Howard by other students is what is for you shall not pass you. But you kind of get sick of hearing that when you're in the waiting stages, when you're waiting to hear back from an organization or just, you know, figuring out what's going on next. However, I did not realize how important these two quotes were until it affected me. Although I was blessed with a lot of amazing experiences and the ability to serve you all for 2 years during my time in council, my last election did not go according to plan. As expected, initially I was devastated, and then an overwhelming sense of peace came over me, and I was reminded of those two quotes once again. If you are afraid to fall, you will never stand, and what is for you shall not pass you. I recognized that this was not a decline, but more so of a realignment that allowed me to step into my true purpose. It's so easy to get caught up in the glitz and glam in Howard, but when the curtains close, you have to sit in the mirror and be happy with who you are and where you're going. I always told myself, and I always told my parents too, that I wanted to be a lawyer. I even studied for the LSAT for 6 months. So shout out to everybody going to law school. Give yourselves a round of applause. Yes, y'all deserve it. But after my first day interning at a law firm, I changed my mind. I recognized that I wanted to find the route that would be the easiest to break generational curses in my family and not the route that made me happy. The thing about Howard is that it molds you into a completely different person and gives you the confidence to be authentically you when everyone else may not see the vision. So with that, I decided to follow my heart because when you're passionate about something, it doesn't feel like work. After losing my cousin due to gun violence in 2017, I got involved with March for Our Lives, which is a youth-led gun violence prevention organization that has mobilized hundreds and thousands of people. This is the kind of work that gets me up every day, and so I'm excited to share that I'll be moving to Chicago to work for the only Black-led national gun violence prevention group. Yes. So whether you are pursuing a career in law, politics, academia, social sciences, or still figuring out what's next, walk away from Howard with your head held high. We survived a pandemic, the transition from Blackboard to Canva, every Carol Dudley email, and so much more. Shout out to Carol Dudley. So taking this moment of realizing you are graduating from the illustrious Howard University, the place where everyone wants to be, but few are chosen. You are chosen. It's now our duty to go out into the world where we will no longer be an environment where everyone looks like us, but to still rise to the occasion and embody our university's motto of in truth and service. Thank you so much.
We didn't make forever, but we must go our separate ways. And now we're standing here helpless, looking for something to say. We've known each other a long time, we didn't think it would end. We were always so close to each other, you were always my friend. And it's hard to say goodbye, my love, hard to see you cry, my love, hard to open up that door when you're not sure what you're going for. We didn't want this to happen, but we shouldn't feel sad. We were always so close to each other.
The most powerful entity on campus is the voice of our students. When you are in their presence, they demand attention, command respect, and embody wit and excellence. If indeed a few are chosen, Mariah, let me tell you what. You represent the illustrious Howard University with integrity, the je ne sais quoi that it demands. And as your COAS leaders, we are honored to be of service to such amazing young scholars. And now, I have the distinct honor of introducing our keynote speaker, Dr. Karim Merrick. He is a Washington, D.C. native. In 2004, he graduated in the College of Arts and Sciences with a major in biology and a minor in chemistry. In 2009, he graduated from Howard University's College of Dentistry, becoming a doctor of dental surgery. During his tenure at Howard University, he was elected as an undergraduate trustee. He was an MBRS research scholar, a Barbara Jordan health policy scholar, a Project Excellence scholar, a Robert C. Byrd scholar, and a member of the Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated Beta Chapter. Upon graduating from Howard University in 2009, he completed his general practice residency at Interfaith Medical Center in Brooklyn, New York in 2010. Dr. Merrick became the youngest director of oral health services at Harlem United, designing dental mobile units dedicated to integrating socially and economically disenfranchised people into a healthy and healing community by going directly into the neighborhoods with the greatest need. During this time, he served as faculty instructor of clinical dental medicine at Columbia University and New York University's Advanced Education General Dentistry programs. Dr. Merrick then went on to become the vice president of dental services at Sun River Health, one of the largest federally qualified health care centers in New York City. He is currently the chief dental officer of Gotham Health of New York Health and Hospitals, what he calls his greatest challenge yet. As a trailblazer in clinical and community dentistry, Dr. Merrick has been featured in the Washington Post, the Black Enterprise magazine, and was named top 50 dentist in New York City. Mm-hmm. I present you our keynote speaker and alumnus, Dr. Karim Merrick.
Thank you, Dr. Francis, Dr. Patterson, and all the dedicated faculty and staff of the College of Arts and Sciences, the flagship of Howard University. I'd like to express my deepest gratitude for the privilege of addressing the graduating class of 2023, Humanities and Social Sciences. HU. Let me hear the ladies. HU. Let me hear the fellas. HU. All right. Harley home, but always repping. So my niece Vi, last time I spoke, my niece Vi told me that to make sure I mentioned her name this go round. So I'll do one better, and I'll tell her a story about her daddy that she does not know. So Dr. Merrick, also Dr. Merrick, him and I, growing up, we weren't the most exceptional students through middle school. We started to turn it around in high school. And my brother was, he made possible for me to succeed. Anytime he went through a course, had a teacher, he would give me notes, tell me how to pass the course. So in retrospect, I was just as smart as he was. He was just giving me the guidance that I needed to succeed. Where he would crawl, I would fly. So one day I got my first 4.0, and my brother got the worst GPA he had ever gotten in his life. So we went home, and he showed my mom his report card, and I mean, he might still be on punishment today. So I showed my report card, you know, my 4.0, I'm beating my chest, I'm ready, I say it with my chest, you know, mom, take a look at this, what we got, what we doing. And my mom looks at the report card for about 2 minutes, and she looks up at me and says, "You got 6 tardies. What is that about?" So it was at that point that I realized what Howard Excellence meant. And there was always room for improvement. So my mom, she was an immigrant from Antigua, and she came to Washington, D.C. to pursue a nursing degree at Howard. It was right here in the Valley, when trying to prepare for a chemistry course, that she met my father, a medical student who was also disguised as a chemistry tutor. My father, also an immigrant from Trinidad, didn't take a whole day to recognize sunshine. My father, also an immigrant from Trinidad, did not take a whole day to recognize sunshine or a good thing. So after some time, you guessed it, he went in there, my mom was chemistry tutor, and came out there, my daddy. My father would describe to me as a young man how exceptional and how a woman was. They are one of one, and their love story persists till today. And there's more. That same brother who found success, also a Howard grad and doctor, and proved to be a better listener than me, ended up marrying Miss Howard University. Way out of his league. You see, my older brother, younger sister, and I would spend the rest of our youth being immersed in the culture that was the Mecca. My father worked as an ER doc at Howard University Hospital, and this was a much different time in D.C. This was during the crack epidemic, where D.C. was the murder capital of the world. And I used to ask, I mean, it was, you know, war-torn countries, it's Afghanistan, Iraq, and this was the murder capital of the world. My father would work as an ER doc, and my mom was just a few floors up working as a nurse at Howard University Hospital as well. These were two medical professionals trained at Howard University, serving black and brown faces in the greatest need. My first dental appointment was at Howard University Dental School, the same dental school that I would graduate from years later. When I chipped my tooth, I thought my life was over. I looked in the mirror and couldn't even recognize myself. I asked that poor Howard University dental student what materials he would use. Would he get the shape of the teeth right? Would the shade look right? Would it look good next to my other teeth in comparison? I mean, I took so much clinical time away from that poor dentist. He probably was late to every appointment afterwards. Little did he know, he was carving a place in my imagination, in my life, that would change it forever. I'll never forget that young dentist telling me as a young man, in order to see decay, you must know life. That ride back home, I thought about that the entire time. My pediatrician was at Howard University Hospital. Lawyers, doctors, reverends, engineers, architects, surgeons, US vice presidents, professors, teachers, Supreme Court justices, scientists, botanists, PhDs, even the squirrels in the valley, all black. This was an island of individuals in academia in the middle of the nation's capital that had the most brilliant minds in the world. It was such a pleasure to grow up in this space. I wanted to wear scrubs and be just like my mother and father and take people out of pain, guide them towards better health, and make them more confident in themselves. As children, my siblings and I realized that there was never a reason to idolize strangers on television or magazines because our idols lived under the same roof as we did. They walked these same halls. They walked in the yard. They changed our lives without even knowing it many times. I pridefully share all of this family Howard lineage as a concrete example of what this university has produced. My story is one of Howard excellence. There are many, many stories of Howard excellence and legacy that comprise these grounds. At the same time, we are not a monolith or people, a monolith of individuals or people. Like we said earlier, some of you are very first generation, and you first generation success stories. Now, I challenge and charge you to begin your legacy today. Some of you have parents and grandparents, or even great-grandparents who have been there with the expectation that the mantle be taken to even greater heights. Look at the friends and colleagues that you've shared these past few years. There is so much diversity amongst our people. Black and brown faces from all over the world. Cultures collide, accents begin to get understood, styles integrated, and customs learned. Some of you came into DC not understanding or liking go-go. Now you probably like at least one song, at least one song. Our stories are the ladders that allow those who come after us to touch the stars. We are the beneficiaries of the labor, courage, blood, sweat, and tears of the generations who came before. These are the stories that you don't hear often on the media outlets or in the midst of the world's standardized assessments of our people. This is the privilege that we have earned when we join the ranks of Howard greats. With privilege that we have gained comes a great responsibility. We must not be selfless with our privilege. We must not abuse it either. There are many who are smart enough, talented enough, and capable enough that simply could not be afforded the opportunity to call themselves graduates of Howard University. Some of them will remain the most vulnerable parts of our society from the same communities that we hail. The effect that you have on others, whether through your leadership, service, volunteering, or even simple conversation, is the most valuable currency that we have. Pay it forward. Find your passion, find your mission. Greatness comes from the courage to create, the ability to inspire, to make a difference in your community, and to make a difference in someone's life. Qualities like kindness, compassion, honesty, and hard work, they precede all other influences. This is the legacy that you now join, that you now carry. This is the legacy that must live on. You take on the mantle of sacrifice and perseverance that have paved this journey, whose destination is completely up to you, and the possibilities are endless. Today is just the beginning for you. Today, part of your legacy is forged in Bison Blue. Most of you are sophomores, dealing with the pandemic that was COVID, having to leave campus altogether and remote learn from March 2020 to about August 2021. Being adaptable, being resilient, has been the identity of your class. You've learned to maximize your opportunities and with your time with one another, because the blow you felt when experiences with your friends and colleagues was unpredictably taken from you. When you arrive back on this campus, you embrace those opportunities again. It seems almost innate that Howard men and women do not accept the things that do not serve them or for the betterment of themselves, the family, and our people. Every new generation of Howard students seems to fight for what they believe in through protests, whether at the steps of the Supreme Court or in our own A building. Your class represented one of the longest and most inspirational protests with the sit-in for 30 days. I admired that. You even protest for the salaries of the professors and faculty to be improved, which is very honorable. You all have so much of the spirit of those who came before you. The future is looking so bright. There are no group of individuals who are better positioned to stand on the foundation of Howard excellence than you. I want to leave a few points for all of you to take with you, because today is the beginning of great things to come. Do not be discouraged by failure. Failure will happen, and its purpose is to learn from it. Make good trouble. As much as we have advanced so many causes, we still have so much further to go. Surround yourself around people who are not only supportive, but those you can learn from. You know if someone has your best interests at heart, your circles and networks can be the springboard that catapults you to the next level. Learning is a lifelong process. You will never reach a point where you know it all, no matter how advanced your degree. The moment you stop learning is the moment that you forfeit to ignorance. Ego is the anesthesia that deadens the pain of stupidity. Hold on to your youthful, positive, and ambitious dreams. The monotony of life and its responsibilities can erode your imagination and your confidence. You know where you came from and what fueled you to get to this point. Continue to tap into that. Remember, with a heart full of gratitude, optimism is sustainable. Congratulations to the class of 2023. Now go on and change the world.
Thank you so much, Dr. Merrick. And now, the moment you've been waiting for. The presentation of candidates for degrees. Now, be very careful. We are going to call you by major, okay? So that your department chairs, your respective department chairs, can shake your hand, okay? Family and guests, please show courtesy by refraining from leaving your seats to take pictures or by talking to the graduates. I know you will. I know you will. We want to make sure that everybody gets a chance to hear the name of the candidates. Please stay away from the processional area, the graduate seats, and the stage area. We need graduates to have easy access to their seats. Also, we have official photographers who will take your children's photos during the processional and during the distribution of diplomas. We thank you for your cooperation. With that, I am passing the mic over to Associate Dean Lewis.
Would the candidates for the degree of the Bachelor of Arts from the Department of African Studies please stand and approach the stage?
Sheba Tart, magna cum laude.
Would the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts from the Department of Afro-American Studies please stand and approach the stage?
Marquissa Sandra Smith Harden. Nadia Farmer summa cum laude. Yanalva Ferrario, summa cum laude. Mula Bay. Cyan Martinique Nicole Gauche. Haviland Felder, summa cum laude.
Will the candidates from the degree for the degree of the Bachelor of Science of Bachelor of Arts from the Department of Economics please stand and approach the stage.
Matthew Marchbanks. Skylar Shaw, cum laude. James Rampershan. Kamari Black, cum laude. No, sir. Ezekiel Joshua Robin Moore, summa cum laude. Space. Ryan Berry, cum laude. Bailey Nelson, magna cum laude. Joanisha Deshae Smith, cum laude. Otaniyu? Yes. Otaniyua Ewe, magna cum laude. Jordan Hill, magna cum laude. Ezra Montero, magna cum laude. Mm-hmm. I love your name. Shadera. Shiabawa. Aneka. Mobau. Magna cum laude. Chiope Bellamy, summa cum laude. Ezra Eliza Roche Robinson. Habib Rahman. Kingsley Ohanaji, cum laude. Kamani Mark Andrews, cum laude. Alexander Taylor, magna cum laude. Ashley Graham, cum laude. Kendall Best. Rayshawn Williams, cum laude. Edward Henry. Romani Mayers, magna cum laude.
I know this name.
Demetrius Palmer, summa cum laude.
Jermani Bird.
Jermani Bird.
The candidates for the degree of the Bachelor's of Arts from the Department of English, please stand and approach the stage.
Nicole Austin. Destiny Cohen, cum laude. Jada Pinkett, magna cum laude. Alexis Brianna Jenkins, magna cum laude. Cameron Wright, magna cum laude. Nyla Jones, summa cum laude. Kaya Frazier, summa cum laude.
Yes, Kaya.
Madison Robinson, summa cum laude. Santana Alexandra Lynn Lewis, magna cum laude. Jada Nicole Brown, cum laude. Tavon Michael Lewis. Brooklyn Jarrett, summa cum laude. Jete Joyner. Zion Moskal, summa cum laude. Sloan Ray Williams, cum laude. Taylor Ashley Tapley, magna cum laude.
Candidates, you may be seated. Would the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts from the Department of History please stand and approach the stage?
All right, History. Naomi Roche, magna cum laude. Brianna Jones, cum laude. Kyler Hughes, cum laude. Zora McKissick, summa cum laude. Tiffany Moore, summa cum laude. Alyssa Kahn, magna cum laude.
Would the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts from the Department of Interdisciplinary Studies please stand and approach the stage?
Grace Christine McLean, summa cum laude. Najia Kirkley, magna cum laude. Olivia McDonald, summa cum laude. Yaya Adib Bey, cum laude. Ayana Jones, magna cum laude. Shania Frazier, summa cum laude. Rachel Freeman, magna cum laude. Okay, oh my bad. Brooklyn Lowry, magna cum laude. Jayla Pitts Glasgow, summa cum laude. Iftu Abidi, cum laude. Nema Taha, cum laude. Danielle Andrews, summa cum laude. Luna Bayane, cum laude.
What is name?
Oh Lord. Hirut Townsend Tamaha. Tafisa. Magna, cum laude, double major. Jayla Wade.
Yeah, J-Lo.
Come on, honey bun. Sierra G. Summa cum laude. Sumaya El Kasha, magna cum laude. Lydia Gabasini, summa cum laude. Dorothy Simon, summa cum laude. Sydney Nicole Walters, summa cum laude. Demetrius Palmer, summa cum laude, double major. Isabella Christina Molson, magna cum laude. Mariam Faharajala, magna cum laude. Milan McKee, summa cum laude. Delaney Marie Buckner, cum laude. Soraya Wright. Tamaya Michelle Matthews, summa cum laude, double major. Tiffany Moore, summa cum laude.
Candidates, you may be seated. Would the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts from the Department of Philosophy please stand and approach the stage?
Miles Taylor, cum laude. Nia Grumdy, summa cum laude. Jamila Robinson, summa cum laude. Dean Ray Sykes Jr., summa cum laude.
Would the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts from the Department of Political Science
Alexander, summa cum laude. Athens, Barnes, cum laude. Janelle Yvonne Beeman, summa cum laude. Kevin Morgan, cum laude. Jaden Christian Kirkendall. Lizanne Ricketts, summa cum laude. Micah Nichelle Dixon. Antoinette Lamika Robinson, magna cum laude. Jameson Blair Jenkins, cum laude. Hannah Elaine Cricklin, summa cum laude. Taylor Nash, summa cum laude. Jasmine Ford, magna cum laude. Nadia Paige Anderson, cum laude. Kenyatta Newby. Sorry. One more time. Kenyatta Asia Newby. Devon Javon Reed Rivera, cum laude. Of course. Kyle Vise, cum laude, double major. Aaliyah Lott, cum laude. Phoenix Tracy, magna cum laude. Zephaniah Aditu, Betty Jala, magna cum laude. Alderman Chow. Jordan Nicole Early, magna cum laude. Kevon Elzy, summa cum laude.
Terry, I love you too.
Terry Anton Jones Jr., cum laude.
Mama, we made it!
Anaya Hicks, summa cum laude, double major. Jada Pete, magna cum laude. double major. Julius Washington. Justina Blanco, summa cum laude. Dia Trailere, summa cum laude. Lloyd Davis, cum laude. Damon Mitchell, magna cum laude. Abram Cleveland, magna cum laude. Carisha Daly, magna cum laude. Samaj Fraser Menace, cum laude. Desmond Campbell, magna cum laude. Hirut Amark Townsend Taflisha, magna cum laude. Layla Von Ellen McCann, summa cum laude. Sarah Slaughter, summa cum laude. Elon Jones, summa cum laude. Sydney Jean, summa cum laude. David W. Hawkins, Jr. Desiah Khalees Mitchell, summa cum laude. Ariana Moody, cum laude. Justin Garcia. Turin Sanaya Jones, magna cum laude. Kaya George, cum laude. Kaya, my apologies. Huss Charles, cum laude. Samantha Dume, double major. Taylor Thompson, magna cum laude. Logan Rattler, cum laude. Naya Conrad, cum laude. Mercy Omari, summa cum laude. Taylor Abompalor, magna cum laude. Fendia Naomi Bryant, cum laude. Camille, Luis, Meshach, Summa, Cum Laude. Amanda, Hannah, Summa, Cum Laude. Elizabeth, Speckhart, Magna, Cum Laude. Joshua, Sierra, Carter, double major. Michaela Jones, summa cum laude.
Tejada.
Miguel Angel Pinto Taha.
Pena.
Pena Taha, summa cum laude.
Hi, Nami.
Michaela Phillips, summa cum laude.
Easy, man. I can do this.
Dream Bryant, summa cum laude. Megan Wright, summa cum laude. Sanaya Aaliyah, Sanaa Aaliyah, artist, magna cum laude. Sydney Taylor, summa cum laude. Naomi Simone McLean, Mosier, magna cum laude. Fala Shade Alford, summa cum laude.
Big Red.
Layla Spicer, summa cum laude. Nandi Longshipman, magna cum laude. Tykeesa Nesbitt, summa cum laude. Miracle Miller, summa cum laude. Jasmine Sharp, magna cum laude. Awal Youssef, summa cum laude. Alexandra Simone Ellis, summa cum laude. Davina Scott, magna cum laude. Carrie Ann Amanda Forbes, summa cum laude. Deloria Durant, magna cum laude. Roandra Londell, magna cum laude. Hannah Grace Esther McLeod, cum laude. Hannah Elizabeth Brown, magna cum laude.
I know.
Tiana Arnold, magna cum laude. Dea, De Amor, cum laude. Shelby Renee Fountain, magna cum laude. Zaria Chapman, summa cum laude. Julianne Leitrin, magna cum laude. Elsabeth Madistu, magna cum laude. Willie Allen. Carly Spencer Faulkner, summa cum laude. Rebecca Reyes, magna cum laude. Josiah Andre Charles Jacobs, magna cum laude. Makai Walker. Jessica Morton, magna cum laude. Samantha Michelle Nichols, cum laude. Tasia Lynn Peterson.
Yes, I am.
Jonathan Michael Fisher. Cornelius Marion Clemens, magna cum laude. Linda Achille, magna cum laude. Aisha Taha, magna cum laude. Katrina Collins, summa cum laude.
Hey, baby.
Donroy Ralston Ferdinand Jr., magna cum laude. Alex Michael Delano, magna cum laude.
Hi, baby. Don't do it. I'm trying to hold, let me hold it together.
Destiny Diamond Krista Cancelar, cum laude. Rebecca Pierce, cum laude. Isaiah Dawson. Joyce Deponme. Haviland Fielder, double major, summa cum laude. Naya Iman Christian, magna cum laude. Morgan, Angenique, Phillips, Magna, cum laude.
Hi, baby.
Kaylin, Proctor, summa, cum laude. Lauren, Goodman, magna, cum laude. Lauren, Brown, summa, cum laude. Zakara, Goodwin. Kaylin, Watson, summa, cum laude. Chalice Cotton. Octavian, Iman, Gill, summa, cum laude. Caleb, Jeffries, magna, cum laude. Evan Kendall Quaintance, magna, cum laude. Kristen Williams, summa, cum laude. Justice Isaiah Crawford. Rhea Aaliyah Beulah. Sahadid summa cum laude.
Hi, baby. Don't do it to me.
Lauren Thorme. Lauren Sakai Greta Thorme. Magna cum laude. Ryan Pinson cum laude.
I know you.
Sharon Luwal. Ray Jennings, summa cum laude. Ashley Neesmith.
Don't look at me.
Ian Alexander Moet, magna cum laude. Eliana Baptista, summa cum laude.
Get away from me.
Solomon Garfield Morgan, summa cum laude.
Stay back. Leave me alone. Leave me alone.
Amen. Haile Selassie, summa cum laude.
Y'all gonna kill me.
Morgan Skinner, summa cum laude.
Hi, baby.
Carlos Eldridge Jr., magna cum laude.
Names, Jesus.
Yasmin Greer, summa cum laude.
Hey, honey.
Brandon James Henry, magna cum laude. Lamarius, Danley, magna cum laude. Leighton V. Jordan Jr., summa cum laude. Don't do it to me. Turn your face that way. Don't look at me. Don't look at me. I love you, baby. Allison Smith, magna cum laude. Mariah Brianna Cooley, magna cum laude. You can't hug me. I told y'all not to hug me. Naeem Ala Banks, summa cum laude. Tamaya Michelle Matthews, summa cum laude. Ryan Sierra Lewis, magna cum laude. Wesley Gomes, magna cum laude. Savannah Sheree Flag, summa cum laude.
I love you. Let me say what I got to say.
Lyric Zane Amodia, magna cum laude.
Hi, baby.
Tahari Williams, cum laude.
I know. Don't leave me alone. Leave me alone.
Erica Annabelle Clark, summa cum laude.
You're welcome, baby. You're welcome. Y'all got the
Would the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts from the Department of Sociology and Criminology please stand and approach the stage?
Shanice McClover Lee, magna cum laude. Destiny Harris. Sabrina Burgess Garrett, summa cum laude. Tyra Champagne, summa cum laude. Ashley Brittany Miller, magna cum laude. Hey, how are you? Isaiah Godman. Kennedy Alexis Richardson, cum laude. Tavonia Jeter, Jira, summa cum laude. Quintera Brown, magna cum laude. Anaya Hicks, double major, summa cum laude. Robert James, cum laude. Kessie Kendall Island, cum laude. Coley Foster, summa cum laude. Lily Eselfi, magna cum laude. How are you? Micah Cook. Okay. Jada Monet Upson, summa cum laude. Anaya Norris, summa cum laude. Ayode Adebiyi, cum laude. Quinton Williams, cum laude. Darian Brockenbore, cum laude. Right? Yeah. Bryce Miller. Anim Dankwa. Isaiah, Josiah Kroots. How is it? Danielle Andrews, double major, summa cum laude. Diamond Weeks, cum laude. Naya Evan, summa cum laude. Kamara Mia Brooks, double major. Tajalia Nasia Hill, cum laude. Nadrat Doinsola Eme, summa cum laude. That was a long one. Say it again. Aliyah Bisre, cum laude. Terry Ann, Michaela Levin, summa cum laude. Huh? Damali Adonia Donaval. Dorothy Simon, summa cum laude. Asia. Asia Naomi Holt Harris, magna cum laude. Samantha Powell. Tania Edney. Tania Edney, summa cum laude. Novel. Novel Jordan, magna cum laude. Hi, how are you? Malia Watts, magna cum laude. Mnet Simignola, summa cum laude. Kiana? Okay. Kiana Jackson, magna cum laude. Akela McKay, cum laude. Jeffrey Miller, magna cum laude. Kiana. Kiana R. Morgan, summa cum laude.
How are you?
Chelsea.
Brianna Oliver.
Brianna? Oh, Chelsea Brianna R. Oliver.
Olivia, yeah.
Olivia, summa cum laude. Jedda Nicole Brown, double major cum laude. Ronald Jackson Carter Jr. Mia Samar Wandera, cum laude. Kalia Maria Exum Santos, summa cum laude. Kelly Aoga, summa cum laude. Kenyani Shante Wright, magna cum laude. Malika Adoli, cum laude. Tracy Mosley. Jakaya Allen Hero, magna cum laude. Akosio Bintuan, summa cum laude. Alicia Sylvain, summa cum laude.
How are you?
Michaela Cara, Michaela Cara, cum laude. Thank you.
Let's go, guys.
Juliana Elise Ostrich, summa cum laude. Mecca Daly. Katia Saladin, magna cum laude.
Zooming.
Michaela Elder, summa cum laude. Sadana Fleming, summa cum laude. Jane Champagne Christina, magna cum.
Say it again.
Okay. Ajani Lane Caro, summa cum laude. Paula Clark, summa cum laude. Kendall Peterson, summa cum laude. Sana Faith Palmer, cum laude. Sokna for magna cum laude. Kayla Stokes. Kyla Stokes. Tyson Elise Menis, summa cum laude. Desire Brooks. Maya Jones, cum laude. Hope Gannis, magna cum laude. Alexa Johnson. Alexi Johnson, magna cum laude. Michelle Moore. Nashel Moore. No. Michaela Kiara Senegal, magna cum laude. Naomi Simon Chen, magna cum laude. Mahun, Nahim, Allah, Bex. Summa cum laude.
Candidates, you may be seated. Would the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts from the Department of World Languages and Cultures please stand and approach the stage?
Sumaya Akasri, summa cum laude. Kayla Jacobs. Ada Omogu, magna cum laude. Jada Peets, magna cum laude, double major.
All right, so we're gonna do a quick redo for the candidates for the degree of the Bachelor's of Science. Please approach the stage from the Department of Human Health Performance and Leisure Studies and the Department of Psychology.
Charles Marshall. Kiana Tracy Toppin. Okay. Candice Ohini, magna cum laude. Kyle Wiese, cum laude. Yep. Kamora Mia Brooks. Michaela Bradley.
Now, we're not done. This now concludes the presentation of candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts, but we also have a few special awards to give out before we close. We are now going to give out the awards for the highest GPA in each program. Our department chairs will come forward to present one at a time their awardees. And first up is the representative for African Studies. Is Dr. Kamara here, or his representative? Perfect.
On behalf of the faculty of the Department of African Studies, I have the esteemed pleasure to introduce to you Ms. Sheba Tart, who has a 3.78 GPA, the highest in our department. Congratulations.
Criminology? Oh, Afro-American Studies.
For the Department of Afro-American Studies, with a GPA of 3.94, Haviland Felder.
On behalf of the faculty of the Department of Economics, I have the esteemed pleasure to introduce Chioki Bellamy, who has a GPA of a 3.94, the highest GPA in our department. Congratulations.
On behalf of the faculty of the Department of English, I have the distinct pleasure to introduce Kaya Fraser, who has a GPA of 3.97, the highest in the Department of English. Congratulations, Kaya.
On behalf of the faculty of the Department of World Languages, I have the esteemed pleasure to introduce to you Sumaya El-Kashif, who has a GPA of 3.71, the highest in the Department of World Languages. Congratulations. And on the behalf of the faculty of the Department of World Languages, I have the esteemed pleasure to introduce to you Ada Umeugu. Yeah, who has the highest GPA of 3.73. Her major is Spanish. Congratulations.
Hello, everyone. On behalf of the Department of Political Science, the faculty, the staff, and everyone, it is my great pleasure to introduce three of our highest achievers. Lauren Brown, who has a GPA of 4.0. Zaria Chapman, who has a GPA of 4.0. And Amin Haile Selassie, who has a GPA of 4.0.
On behalf of the faculty of the Department of History, I have the esteemed pleasure of introducing to you Zora McKissick, who has also a 4.0. History is Chasing Political Science, the highest GPA in the Department of History. Congratulations, Zora. We also have another student, Tiffany Moore, also from the Department of History, who also has a 4.0 GPA, the highest GPA in the Department of History. Congratulations, Tiffany.
On behalf of the faculty of the Department of Interdisciplinary Studies, I have the distinct pleasure to introduce to you, so don't go too far, Tiffany Moore, who has a GPA of 4.0, the highest GPA, Department of Interdisciplinary Studies.
Thank you.
On behalf of the Department of Sociology, I have the honor to introduce you to three students, all of whom earned a 4.0 GPA. Akasawa Bitterum. Sydney Nicholson. And Kendall Peterson.
On behalf of the faculty of the Department of Philosophy, I have the esteemed pleasure to introduce to you Jamelia Robinson, who graduates with a GPA of 3.92.
And I believe that, Lyric, you wanted to give us a prayer before we go into our farewell.
Greetings, graduates, respected faculty, and honored guests. Before we close out this beautiful ceremony, I wanted to read a scripture from Numbers 6:24 through 26. And I ask for this for the graduating class of 2023. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace as you move forward into the beautiful accomplishments that you will achieve. Thank you.
Greetings to Dean Patterson, the College of Arts and Sciences, faculty and staff, proud parents, and above all, my fellow graduates of the class of 2023. And for the last time ever, I know you guys heard it twice, but my Howard intro. My name is Naheem Allah Banks, and I am a graduating senior, honors political science and criminology double major from Los Angeles, California. And I'm gonna begin with something that I think a lot of Howard students really like feel in their soul, and I'm probably gonna join along when I say, I used to pray for times like this to rhyme like this, so I had to grind like this. I spent with some locked up. Yeah, I got five minutes. They will not be paying the Grammy Award music during my speech, no ma'am. But again, it is truly a privilege to be able to stand up here today and offer the farewell remarks on behalf of our class. And let me just say, for the class of 2023, to paraphrase the words of Du Bois, the honor, I assure you, was Howard's. When I was first asked to give this speech and I first began to craft this reflection, I really struggled with what to say to you all. I didn't know whether to talk about, you know, the Howard finesse that got us all here today, or, or maybe the life-altering events that really have shaped our matriculation. But as I stand before you today, I'm reminded of why I chose to attend Howard in the first place. See, growing up in Los Angeles County, I always seemed surrounded by an unjust criminal legal system that operates under the guise of justice. In a nation where we have the highest prison population of people made up mostly of black men and women, Howard offered me the chance to study the radical black politics of the United States, while also teaching me to understand and analyze the building blocks, actions, and behaviors of society under some of the greatest black minds in our modern history. Taking classes with professors like Dr. Muhammad, Dr. Mack, who also served as my thesis advisor, yes ma'am, and Dr. Kinlock really expanded my level of consciousness. Howard taught me that theory is not just descriptive, explanatory, or substantiated, but that it should also be critical. To be at the Mecca of black political, philosophical, and scientific thought was liberating to me. The legacy of Howard is that of social engineers. And it's not only as graduates of the Mecca, but as social engineers, we have a responsibility to combat the injustices we see in our society, including attacks on our black women, unjust police killings of black people across the nation, and an increasingly corrupt judiciary. See, when I first walked these halls, my parents dropped me off at Charles Aldrew Hall just down the street. I was really immediately confronted with students from across the black diaspora. Now, if you stayed in Drew Hall, like a normal person, sorry, could call kids, yes sir, yes sir. You met some of your best friends there. But as we began our freshman year, I think everyone can say that HU 2023 really came in swinging. We were beating upperclassmen in elections, interning on the Hill, and even FLA was still a thing on campus. But suddenly, halfway through our first year, we were placed on lockdown, rushed home due to the COVID-19 pandemic, and had to finish our classes online. Howard said, y'all can't come back here. Y'all gotta go somewhere else, y'all. So we finished our classes online. We spent our entire sophomore year on Zoom and somewhat lost that connection we had when we first arrived on campus. It wasn't until fall of 2021, after a year of not seeing each other, that we would be back on campus, only to then experience a 34-day protest, a cyber attack, constant bomb threats, and constantly waiting for Bison safe to load so that we can go to class. You see, these experiences we've had together really showed us the constant challenges that we will face once we exit what is known as the Howard bubble. But it also showed our resilience in the face of adversity. During my time at Howard, a lot of you have come to know me as, you know, the Houston Senate guy. I lived, breathed, and spoke Senate. Being in these spaces of advocacy for students really reinforced my advocacy for the little guy, and that's why I'm continuing to pursue that passion as a public defender and a civil rights attorney. But I want you all to know that in this world and in this country, we are often going to come in contact with people that will not celebrate our diversity of hair, our skin color, or our culture. You're going to come across people that are going to try and limit your potential and your power. But one thing that Howard taught me is that to be a lion, you must train with lions. And one thing that Howard taught me as well, and I know has taught the rest of you, is the confidence and strength that comes with being young, gifted, and black. Yes, ma'am. When I first came to Howard, I was really afraid to be here. I came here a little whitewashed, sometimes like a lot of us do, thinking our blackness was something to be hidden in order to succeed in a growing white world, and I couldn't live up to or compare it to my fellow classmates. I also came here with, you know, less style, less HBCU drip, two less piercings in my ear, no facial hair, wearing glasses. But the Howard glow up wasn't the only thing I think me and my classmates took away from the university. It was the power of change and adaptability. You see, the powerful are constantly adapting, and their power comes from the speed at which they can change. And while many of us will be exposed to unfamiliar waters after we graduate, some further pursuing their education, some going into the workforce, or some just simply taking a break from all the academics, change may be difficult, but change can also be beautiful. Change is coming into Howard differently than how you are leaving. Change is understanding your agency in your own life. Change is growing. Change is realizing that we can't party at Banneker with the freshmen anymore. Change is realizing, change is graduating. In HU23, I say to you again, the honor, I assure you, is Howard's. If the honor is Howard's, that means that you are the gift that keeps on giving. If the honor is Howard's, that means that you are your ancestors' wildest dreams. If the honor is Howard, it means that you are poised to succeed. If the honor is Howard's, it means that you are indeed young, gifted, and Black. And if the honor is Howard's, I can't wait to see the change that HU23 will bring about in the world. Howard University, class of 2023, family and friends, thank you from the bottom of my heart for really allowing me to grow not only as a man, but as a young Black man, to grow as a son, a brother, a twin, a friend, and a person. Thank you to my mother and my father, my brother Saheem, and especially my twin sister Sanai, who are both all sitting to the right of me, for showing me the importance of the pursuit for knowledge and for teaching me the value of service for others. Thank you to my grandmother, Mama Linda, who has moved on from this earth, but whose brooch I carry with me because she taught me that kindness and love is helping someone without expecting anything in return. HU23, never stop learning and growing as people. Never stop showing up and showing out. Listen more than you speak. Listen with the will to learn and be secure enough in yourself to base success on personal growth. Assume formlessness and adapt. And I promise nothing will ever stop you because, again, the honor, I assure you, was Howard's. Thank you and congratulations to you all.
Greetings, esteemed faculty and staff, to family and friends, and to HU23, this piece is for you. Howard, the Mecca, I wonder if they knew the pilgrimage to get here. Feet calloused and tear-stained faces spit on by men who share General Howard's legacy. Think he be savior, gave hands out and we made a feast with hands held high, thanking God for making it. But they think you are surrendering. Think that when Black folks raise their hands, there must be a reason other than celebration. How many years to be recognized? For over 150, we have stood to be honored, to be the sea of Black, the name that everyone knows. Aren't we glad we didn't drown? Is that why our colors be blue? To signify those lost in red for the bloodshed in white, to remind us that there will always be someone who doesn't look like us in our suffering. Howard students be so quick with it and fresh to death. See how we make it look easy, never knowing when we will take our last breath. So we stunt today and no one does it better. They say dreams come true here, and I've seen it. From founders to the yard, from Thurgood to Tony, using their bodies to shatter ceilings and giving us their shoulders to rebuild them in Black so we never have to fight again, except when we hear that Howard ain't the real HU, baby. It couldn't be further than true. With our box braids and daily slays, it's hard not to take credit. But I am very clear that it has always been us. Erased his face and sketched our own. We gave that name more meaning than it ever did. So when you think of Howard, think of this room, of you, of me. And it will live on to be ours and ours alone as long as the stars are aligned to the Mecca. Thank you.
Mm-mm-mm. Woo, powerful. Thank you so much for joining us today to celebrate the new Howard University COAS alumni. As we recess, we ask guests to please remain in your seats as we exit, okay? Until the recessional has concluded. Thank you in advance for your cooperation. Merci à nos invités. Merci en pile. Merci. Thank you to our guests, families, and friends who made the journey to Howard
and to the thousands of you joining us online, be safe, be well, and remember, we are excellence. HU!
You're working with some flash, yeah. Get bad, yeah. Make a fella spend the cash, yeah. It's bad, yeah. Girl, you're working with some flash, yeah. Get bad, yeah. Make a fella spend the bag, yeah. It's cash, yeah. Girl, you made it, you made it. Oh, yeah, you made it, you made it. Baby, girl, you made it, you made it. Oh, yeah, you made it, you made it. Been a long time coming. All these blessings rolling in, I ain't even see them coming. Too hard, too hard. I've been going too hard now. They say I need a vacation. Say I need to slow down. And I ain't trying to slow down. Pretty face with a bad attitude. Working like I got too much to lose. Built the up one, two by twos. I wonder now I pay too many dues. Head up in my heels high. This one life's supposed to feel like. Looking like I'm in a gym right. Taking side pics, looking thick like. Girl, you're working with some flash, yeah. Get bad, yeah. Make a fella spend the cash, yeah. It's bad, yeah. Girl, you're working with some flash, yeah. Get bad, yeah. Make a fella spend the bag, yeah. It's cash, yeah. Girl, you made it, you made it. Oh, yeah, you made it, you made it. Baby, girl, you made it, you made it. Oh, yeah, you made it, you made it. No more stressing. I can't control God's time. My heels high. This what life's supposed to feel like. Throw it back now. For the 99 and the 2000. Yeah, 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 yeah. Girl, you're working with some flash, yeah. Get bad, yeah. Make a fella spend the cash, yeah. It's bad, yeah. Girl, you're working with some flash, yeah. Get bad, yeah. Make a fella spend the bag, yeah. It's cash, yeah. Girl, you made it.
My mama calls, see you on TV, sunset. Done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I wouldn't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Work so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing. Look, we made it. Yeah, we made it. They was never friendly, yeah. Now I'm jumping out of Bentley, yeah. And I know I sound dramatic, yeah, but I know how to have it, yeah. For the money, I'm a savage, yeah. I be itching like I had it, yeah. I'm surrounded 20 bags, yeah. But they didn't know me last year, yeah. Everyone wanna act like they important, but all that mean nothing when I saw my door, yeah. Everyone counting on me, drop the ball, yeah. Everything custom like I'm at the bottom, yeah, yeah. If you win it, put your lattice to the sky. How could it all make sense when I got millions on my mind? Coming with it, I just put it to the side. Bought a sense of baby, they could see it in my eyes.
Let's dance in style, let's dance for a while. Heaven can wait, we're only watching the skies. Hoping for the best, but expecting the worst. Are you gonna drop the bomb or not? The music's for the sad man. Ever young, I wanna be forever young. Do you really want to live forever, forever and ever? Forever young, I wanna be.
Hey, may the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. But we ain't even thinking that far.
So we living life like a video. Where the sun is always out and you never get old. And the champagne's always cold and the music.
music's always good. And the pretty girls just happen to stop by in the hood. And they hop their pretty ass up on the hood of that pretty ass car without a wrinkle in today. Cause there's no tomorrow, just a picture perfect day that lasts a whole lifetime. And it never ends, cause all we have to do is hit rewind. So let's just stay in the moment, smoke some, drink some wine, reminisce, talk some, forever young is in your mind. Leave them off, they can't erase neither space nor time. So when the director yells cut, I'll be fine. I'm forever young.
Forever young, I wanna be forever young. Do you really want to live forever? Forever and ever.
Fear not much while we're alive. Life is for living, I'm living uptight. See you somewhere up in the sky. Fear not die, I'll be alive for a million years. Bye-bye, so not for legends, I'm forever young. My name shall survive. Through the darkest blocks, over kitchen stoves, over pirates' pots. My name shall be passed down to generations while debating up in barbershops. Young, slung, hung here, shorter than from here. With a little ambition, just what we can become here. And as the father passed the story down to his son's ears, younger kid, younger every year, yeah. So if you love me, baby, this is how you let me know. Don't ever let me go, that's how you let me know, baby. Let it run. Slamming Bentley doors, hopping out of Porsches, popping up on Forbes list, gorgeous. Hold up, daughter lost it. They be talking, I be talking more. They nauseous. Hold up, I'll be here forever. You know I'm on my fault. I ain't with foreclosure. I will never forfeit less than four bars. Google bring the chorus in. Did you get the picture yet? I'm painting you a portrait of young.
I'm forever young. I wanna be forever young. Forever young. Do you really want to live forever? Forever. Forever young.
You're working with some flash, yeah. Get bad, yeah. Make a fella spend the cash, yeah. It's bad, yeah. Girl, you're working with some flash, yeah. Get bad, yeah. Make a fella spend the bag, yeah. It's cash, yeah. Girl, you made it, you made it. Oh, yeah, you made it, you made it. Baby, girl, you made it, you made it. Oh, yeah, you made it, you made it. It's been a long time coming. All these blessings rolling in, I ain't even see them coming. Too hard, too hard, I've been going too hard now. They say I need a vacation, say I need to slow down. And I ain't trying to slow down. Pretty face with a bad attitude. Working like I got too much to lose. Built the up, one, two, by twos. I wonder now, I pay too many dues. Head up in my heels, this one life's supposed to feel like. Looking like I'm in a gym, right? Take a side pics, looking thick like. Mm-hmm. Girl, you're working with some flash, yeah. Get bad, yeah. Make a fella spend the cash, yeah. It's bad, yeah. Girl, you're working with some flash, yeah. Get bad, yeah. Make a fella spend the bag, yeah. It's cash, yeah. Girl, you made it, you made it. Oh, yeah, you made it, you made it. Baby, girl, you made it, you made it.